Hello everyone, in this video you will learn how to control a character and move it. This object is player and the camera is in its child. Click on player, add a new component called character controller. Change height and center till its size become like player. Open the code and define a character controller called control or anything else. In update void write control.move. Open close parentheses and semicolon. In parentheses you should write a vector 3, which you can write a new vector 3, or up here define a new vector 3 called as move or anything you want, and equal it to new vector 3 in parentheses 0, 0, 0. Now in parentheses write the name of defined vector 3. To change the player speed, if you want the player moves to left and right, change first 0. If you want it moves up and down, change middle 0, and if you want it goes forward and backward, change last 0. For example, instead of x, write 5 times time dot delta time, which if you don't know why, watch the 6 points about time video. Give a script to player and drag the character controller to a script. Now if you press play, player goes to the left side, and if change 5 from positive to negative, player goes to the right side. If you change z instead of x, the character moves forward and backward. If you pay attention, when x is positive 5, the player should go to the right side, or when it's negative 5, the player should go to the left side. Or when the z is positive 5, the player should go forward, or when it's negative 5, it should go backward. But exactly the opposite happens. Why? I will tell the reason ahead. To control the movement, you should put two new variables instead of x and z. So define two floats called z and x, or whatever you want. In continue, we wanna move the character with four main gaming buttons. I mean A, W, S, D. So write in update x equals to input.getAccessRaw in parentheses horizontal and z equals to input.getAccessRaw in parentheses vertical. Don't forget double quotations. Why did we do this? Now you will understand the reason. Press play. If you press A, x number becomes negative 1. If you press D, x becomes positive 1, and if you don't press any buttons, x becomes 0. If you press W, z becomes positive 1, and if you press S, z becomes negative 1, and if you press neither, z becomes 0. Now you just need to put x in x field and put z in z field. Don't forget to multiply them by time.delta time. Now press play. If you press any of A, D, W, S buttons, character will go to the left, right, forward, and backward. But it's too slow. To fix this, open the script. You just need to multiply X and Z by speed. 5 for example. If you press play, the character moves left and right at the appropriate speed. If you change Y number of rotation, after pressing W or S, the character instead of forward and backward goes to the left and right. And if you press A and D instead of left and right, it goes forward and backward. It isn't a problem. This case is used in some third-party games that you are watching. But if your game is first person like this game, this case becomes a problem for you. It's a huge bug. What you must do? Open the script, answer is there. This time, instead of new vector 3 right, transform.right multiplied by defined x times a speed for example 5 times time delta time plus transform dot forward times defined z times speed for example 5 times time dot delta time 5 time. In this way it doesn't matter which way the player turns or looks. If you press W, player goes forward. Press S, goes backward. Press D, goes to the right. And if you press A, player goes left. It doesn't matter what the angle number is, whether it is positive or negative. In next tutorial, you will learn how to look in a direction with mouse, like first person games, and also when you move player with buttons, player automatically turns to that direction. Don't forget to like and subscribe us.